The object of today's experiment is to investigate the transformation of energy and momentum under different conditions of collision. Through this experimental setup, we will investigate two types of collision, the elastic and the inelastic collision. And we will be using this experiment to investigate the validity of certain fundamental laws of collision which govern collision, namely the conservation of momentum and conservation of kinetic energy. We will also use this experiment to evaluate an important parameter encountered in collision, namely the coefficient of restitution. The experimental setup which we will be using is the linear air track experiment. As you know that collisions are very complicated phenomena. However, to simplify this phenomena, we study collisions in one dimension. This is a linear air track. It is a track in which you have holes made on this air track, and through this object, which is an air blower, air is pressurized into this air track at a pressure which is larger than the atmospheric pressure. And we keep these gliders on this air track, and the air actually keeps these gliders floating on this air track, and this prevents friction from entering into our collision. These are the two objects between which we will study the collision between these two objects. We place it on this air track, and as you can see, they are floating on the air track. The air track can be leveled using these screws as shown here by my colleague. For launching the projectile with different velocities, there is a gun here which my colleague will fire the projectile. As you have seen, these gliders move on the air track with a particular velocity, and we will use these photoelectric timers to measure the velocity of these gliders. I will now briefly explain how these timers work. In this timer, there is a light source and there is a detector. Once the light source is interrupted, the timer starts counting. And the timer keeps on counting until the light source, the interruption in the light source is stopped. Namely, once the light comes on, the timer stops counting. Using this, you can measure the interval for which the light is interrupted in the timer. This we will use to measure the velocity of this projectile. So this glider has a flag of 10 centimeters in length. Once the glider enters into the timer, it obstructs the light and the timer starts counting. The timer counts until the glider exits the timer, and you can use this to measure the time taken to cover 10 centimeters of length, thereby deducing the velocity of this glider. Whatever I have described to you till now has been for elastic collisions. You can do the same set of experiments to study inelastic collision and verify the conservation laws for momentum and energy for inelastic collision. In this experiment, you will see that once you launch these two gliders, they will get stuck and move together, thereby showing you the inelastic collision. So this was a brief description of the linear air track experiment, and now please go back and read your manual carefully before coming for the experiment. And in case you still don't understand some things regarding the experiment, please contact your TA associated with the experiment. Thank you. Best of luck.